Like everyone else, I've switched to Cursor from VS Code as my daily driver. Here's two ways that I like to use it to build Sanity configurations and Sanity content. So first of all, I wrote this guide quite a while ago, an opinionated guide to Sanity Studio. It covers how I like to write things like schema definition files and organize files inside of the studio. And what I've done is distilled that into a set of Cursor rules, which it can follow here. So it will know the way that I like to write schema definition files, not just the ways that they are written in documentation. So it'll do things like use groups, use icons, and all of that. So I can start a new chat and add context, which is going to be my Sanity Studio opinionated rules, and say, I am creating content model for an ultra marathon event organization company. I need a new schema type for kit items. Those would be mandatory kit requirements for certain races. And I can submit this away to my agent and it will get to work using my rules and creating schema types in the ways that it understands. Now this is done, I can accept those changes, and let's go and have a look now at the file it created. This is my Sanity schema definition. Great, it uses icons, it uses groups, it set validation, it didn't add titles where they're not necessary, so I can save that. And if we go to the studio now, I can see kit items has been added to my list. I can go and create a new document, and we can see all of these details that have been filled out. So now I've got my content model for these kit items, but what I'd really like is some dummy data to play with. Because Agent can run commands, it means I could do an import command from, say, a dataset export. I need to create fake data for my Sanity Studio dataset. Using the kit item type content schema, create 30 documents with fake data, write them all to an nd.json file, and then import them using the command line npx sanity dataset import. Go for it. Don't wait for me. I trust you. Now let's go ahead and tag the kit item type so it knows what it's looking for. And I'll also update, I said nd.json because it keeps writing nd.json and I don't want it to do that. And we'll also need to give it the CLI command because occasionally it's getting caught up on how to import these documents. So now that we can run this command, it's now stuck on which dataset to import into, but now it is done. And there we go. I have all of my documents. So that's really cool. Cursor can do both of these things, both help us with Sanity Studio configuration, but also with Sanity content. I think that's pretty rad. If you're using Cursor and Sanity, let me know how it's helping you.